This is the Motorola Edge Plus. It's Motorola's first big flagship in like almost 3 years now, if you omit the Motorola Razr, but it honestly looks like the Moto Edge Plus can take on the big guys. I mean, let's just look at the core specs. It's got Snapdragon 865, okay, 12 gigabytes of RAM, I'm listening, 256 gigabytes of storage, it's got a 90 hertz display, it's got a 21:9 aspect ratio. I mean, this seems like they took a lot of specs from other high-end flagships and just smashed it into one phone. Oh, and it even has a headphone jack. Now, okay, that 90 hertz display is on a 1080p panel, but it's also a 21:9 aspect ratio panel. And I think a lot of people might think that this is a little bit tall. Personally, I really like 21:9 displays because they're really more cinematic if you're watching things like movies. Now, a lot of people might not like this because they're going to be a little bit harder to navigate with one hand, but that's why Motorola has added gestures to the sides of the phone to actually allow you to use the phone a little bit easier. Now, Motorola added these really curved sides to this phone. It's almost like a waterfall, but not quite as curved as something like the Huawei Mate 30 Pro. Motorola is adding a bunch of little gestures and things that'll make it a little bit easier to use the phone. So for example, you can swipe down on the right side of that edge and it'll bring down the notification tray. We're obviously gonna have to test this a little bit more once we actually do our full review to see if this is a little bit narrow and a little bit extreme, but I really liked the Sony Xperia 1, so I've got high hopes for this device. Let's dig a little bit into the cameras. It's got the 108 megapixel Samsung ISOCELL sensor that we saw on the Xiaomi Mi Note 10. And no, it's not the same sensor as the one on the Samsung Galaxy S20 Ultra because it's actually a 2x2 bin instead of a 3x3 bin. That basically means that it produces 27 megapixel images instead of 12 megapixel images. But Motorola is letting you shoot 6K video at up to 30 FPS, which is actually really nice middle ground because I didn't love the 8K video on the Samsung Galaxy S20 series. And honestly, I think 6K is a really nice middle ground. You can also take 6K photos while you're shooting video, which is a feature that we've seen in some other phones as well. Now let's talk about the battery. This phone has a 5,000 milliamp hour cell, which is really promising. That's really exciting to see because other phones that have 5,000 milliamp hour cells like the LG V60 or the Samsung Galaxy S20 Ultra got really good battery life in our reviews. Pair that with the 1080p display instead of a 1440p one, and you've got a really, really good battery life phone. Now, obviously, we're gonna have to test this once we actually get our unit because software can lead to a lot of different changes in a phone, but stay tuned for that. Now, if you wanna charge the 5,000 milliamp hour battery, you have a few different options. You've got the 18 watt built-in charger that comes with the phone, and 18 watts, a little bit slow at this point. I would have liked to see at least 25 since that's kind of becoming the standard nowadays. But you can also do 15 watt wireless charging, which Motorola will sell a separate wireless charger that does 15 watts, or you can do 5-watt reverse wireless charging. The Edge Plus also has stereo speakers, and Motorola says that these are the loudest speakers of any smartphone right now. We're definitely going to have to test that. They said they were tuned by Waves Audio, which is this company that has a bunch of Grammy Awards for their audio tuning, so I'm pretty excited to see what this phone sounds like once we have a little bit more time with it. The other cameras are a 16 megapixel wide angle sensor, an 8 megapixel 3x optical telephoto camera that I'm pretty excited about, and a 25 megapixel selfie camera. Of course, this phone doesn't have everything. It's not officially IP68 rated, although Motorola says that they did their own independent testing to pretty much the same standards as IP68, but again, we're gonna have to test that. The other thing it doesn't have is microSD card expansion. However, there will be a Motorola Edge Non-Plus that's going to be releasing in the summer that does have microSD card expansion. Now, this is a cut down version of this phone. It has a Snapdragon 765. It's got 4 to 6 gigabytes of RAM. It's cut down in a lot of different ways, like a 64 megapixel camera instead of the 108 megapixel camera. We'll probably know more about that phone in the future here, but for now we're focusing on the Edge Plus. And of course, you've got the classic Motorola UI that's a pretty simple version of Android. It's not all that different, probably because Google actually owned Motorola at one point, but you've still got all those same actions like double chop for the flashlight, you've got twist to open the camera, and Motorola is adding some other actions to this phone too. So all that sounds pretty good. As far as pricing and availability goes, this phone will cost $999, which is definitely up there, but I'm really interested to see how it actually performs in the real world, because this is a phone that takes a lot of specs from a lot of different phones and kind of smushes them all into one, and it seems like it could be a really, really good flagship. Unfortunately, the Motorola Edge Plus is a Verizon exclusive. So if you were hoping to get this phone on AT&T or Google Fi or T-Mobile, you're not gonna be able to do that. This is kind of a collaboration that Verizon and Motorola have had for a long time. That's why the Motorola Razr was only on Verizon, et cetera, et cetera. It's all complicated and a lot of politics, but that's what you're gonna get. Now, Motorola did say that this phone is coming to other regions in the future, which means it is going to be on other carriers, not Verizon, in other parts of the world, but it will be available from Verizon starting on May 14th. So I'm curious to know, what do you guys think about the Motorola Edge Plus? Personally, I think it looks to be a really exciting flagship, even though it's at pretty much exactly flagship price. So keep in tune to Android Authority. Read my hands-on article on the website. It goes a little bit more in depth than this video does. And until next time, I'll see you in the next video.